वी हैव द ऑब्जेक्टिव वेर इन वी विल ट्राई टू राइट एन असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्राम फॉर एक्सचेंजिंग अ ब्लॉक ऑफ डेटा. सो दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट इज टू एक्सचेंज अ ब्लॉक ऑफ डेटा. बिफोर वी ट्राई टू एक्सचेंज अ ब्लॉक ऑफ डेटा वी विल सी हाउ वी कैन एक्सचेंज अ बाइट ऑफ डेटा. मेनली द एक्सचेंज ऑफ द डेटा विल बी डन बिटवीन IDMs, दैट इज इंटरनल डेटा मेमोरी. वी आर नॉट लुकिंग इन टू द एक्सटर्नल डेटा मेमोरी इन टूडेज एक्सपेरिमेंट. दिस इज प्योरली इंटरनल डेटा मेमोरी, एन एक्सचेंज बिटवीन इंटरनल डेटा मेमोरी. सो हियर आई एम कंसिडरिंग टू एड्रेस लोकेशंस, दैट इज 50H एंड 60H. एंड द कंटेंट दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन 50H, से आई एम कंसिडरिंग इट टू बी 0A. एंड द कंटेंट दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन 60H, से आई एम कंसिडरिंग इट टू बी 0B. सो एज यू कैन क्लियरली सी इट्स अ बाइट ऑफ डेटा दैट यू हैव हियर. सो दिस 0 विल बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एज 000 एंड A कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एज 1010. Similarly, this is another byte of data you have. This can be represented as 0000 and this can be represented as 1011. So this byte of data needs to be exchanged between the address locations 50H and 60H. Since I'm considering IDM, that is why my address locations are in this form. That is why I have considered 50H and 60H. You can consider it to be anything, okay? Just see to it that it is between the internal data memory locations. Now, if I have considered these two contents, 0A and 0B, when I say exchange, that means after the exchange operation, the content present in 50H should be move to 60H and the content present in 60H should be moved to 50H. So you can see here, after the exchange operation, you have the content in 50H to be 0B and the content in 60H to be 0A. So this will be the result of the exchange operation. So if you look at the program that is meant to exchange a byte of data between the IDMs, that is internal data memory locations, you will be able to see a lot of similarity between this program and the program that was meant to move a byte of data. So the only extra additional line of code that you would have is this, that is the exchange operation. It's not just that you are moving the content from one address location to the other, it is that you are exchanging the contents. So that is why you can see here the opcode that is used is exchange, XCH, corresponding to exchange. So here what happens is that, let me start from the beginning of the code. You have ORG 0000H. So this ORG corresponds to the origin of the program. Then this corresponds to the starting address. So you are going to begin with the starting address of 0000H. Then you can see in the previous example which I showed you, we had considered the two address locations 50H and 60H. So initially, whatever content is there in 50H, which I considered it to be 0A, I am moving it to the accumulator. So this is moved to the accumulator. Next, I am exchanging the content which is present in the accumulator with the content present in 60H. And in the example, I considered the content in 60H to be 0B. So this line of code, what it will do is, it will exchange the content between the accumulator and the address 60H. So now the result of this line of code will be, accumulator will contain 0B and 60H will contain 0A. Now what you have basically done is, you have exchanged the content of accumulator and 60H. So whatever content was there in 50H has moved to 60H. But whatever content is there in the accumulator has to be now moved to 50H. So that is why you have this line of code, wherein you can see that the content present in the accumulator is moved to 50H. So now this 0B will move to 50H. So at the end of the program, so this will correspond to end of the program. So now the content in 50H will be equal to 0B, and the content in 60H will be equal to 0A. So at the beginning, this was the condition. And at the end of the execution of the entire program, the contents that were present in 50H and 60H have been effectively moved to, or effectively exchanged to 50H and 60H correctly. So you can see 0A, which was in 50H, is moved to 60H. The content in 60H, which was 0B, has been moved to 50H now. So another thing to be remembered here is that whenever we write these instructions, it's always that this will be the source and this is the destination. So you can see how the program or the line of code is executed. Initially 50H to the accumulator, then exchange between the accumulator and 60H, and finally whatever content is there in the accumulator has been moved to 50H. Let me quickly show you how this will look like when we try to execute using the Keel software. So I will begin first. This is how my Keel window will look like. I will go to project, new Microvision project. And here, let me save this as a PP5. And now I need to choose Atmel. So I have Atmel wireless and microcontroller. So I'll choose that. Under this, I need to choose the device. So I'm going to choose AT89S52 and click on OK. So here I will go to File, New, and whatever program that I require, I'll just copy paste that. So here is the code, and now I will save this. When I save it, I need to save it as an assembly language program. So I'll save it as pp5.asm. And you can see, once it is saved, you can see that here the code color has changed appropriately. Now let me add the required target options. So here I need to choose the crystal frequency 11.0592. and output should be to create an executable hex file. Now let me add pp5.asm. Okay, so let me build the target. I will go to project, build target, and here you can see at the bottom I have zero errors and zero warnings. So everything is proper in my code. So let me quickly debug. Okay, so now I need to select the memory, right? So in the memory I will choose this as DX050. So here I had considered two address locations, 50H and 60H. So in 50H I had chosen 0A, and in 60H I had considered 0B. So this was my initial contents in these locations. So you can see here I placed those contents. Now I will be executing the program. So when I execute the program, at the end of the execution these two contents need to be exchanged. So I'll go to debug again, run, and you can see in the address location 60H the content is now 0A, and in the address location 50H the content is 0B. So let me just bring this window, and you can see in the address location 50H it is 0B and 60H it is 0A. So this is how you exchange a byte of data between two IDMs, internal data memory locations. Now the next part, or the actual experiment that you are supposed to conduct, is wherein you are considering a block of data. So let us come back to the original experiment. That is, we have to write an assembly language program to move a block of data. Again, this is between internal data memory. So let me consider the two blocks of data, because I need to exchange, right? So I'm considering two blocks of data. So this is first block and this is the second block. So here you can see that I am considering the address locations from 20H to 24H and address locations from 30H till 34H in my second block. So basically I need to exchange whatever content is there in 20H up till 24H with the content present in 30H to 34H. That means each and every content of this particular block needs to be exchanged. So 00 needs to be exchanged with 0A. So this data which is present in 20H has to be moved to 30H, and the content present in 21H has to be exchanged with 31H. In a similar manner it has to proceed upwards. So the two blocks, you can see the size of this block is equal to 5. I can consider any block size or array size. In this case, in this example, I have considered 20H to 24H. So the size of the block, you have totally 5 address locations, so size is equal to 5. After the end of the execution of the code, you can see that the result of this should be the exchange between the two blocks of data. So you can see here, the content present in 34H has been exchanged with the content present in 24H. Content present in 23H has been exchanged with content present in 33H. Content present in 22 has been exchanged with content present in 32H, and similarly downwards. So this is the result of operation of the exchange of a block of data. Again, I'm repeating, the array size or the block size can be anything as you choose. In our code, we are considering the size, array size or the block size to be equal to 5. So this example has a block size of 5. Now coming to the explanation of the program. So this is the program to exchange the block of data between EDMs, and in this case, in order to reduce, because I can write the line of code in a similar manner like the way I have done for the exchange of byte of data, but if I'm going to write in those terms, what happens is that it's going to be a lengthier process. To reduce the size of the code, what I have done is that I have chosen various registers here, and in this case I have considered the register R3, I've considered the register R0, and I've considered the register R1. So here this ORG corresponds to the origin, 0000H corresponds to the starting address of the code. Move R3,05H basically corresponds to the block size. So in the register R3, I am storing the array size or the block size 05. Again, to repeat, I have considered the size to be 05. You can choose anything. Okay. Then the two address locations for the two blocks of data that I had considered in the previous example was 20H and 30H, right? So that is why here for register R0, I have considered the starting address to be 20H, and I have considered the register starting address to be 30H. Now, as I mentioned, I want to reduce the size of the code. So that is why in this program, I will be addressing or performing the exchange with respect to the contents that are present in the register. So initially, what I'm going to do is, I have moved the required contents into the register. So you can see this line of code wherein I have move a comma at R0. So move a comma at R0, what this will do is, whatever content is present in R0 will be moved to the accumulator. Now you have to be very careful here. It is the content that is present in R0 is moved to the accumulator. At R0 means the content present in the register R0 is moved to accumulator. In this program, we are nowhere specifying what content is present. So the content can be anything. It is, if you can recall in the previous program also, we had not specified in the line of code what content was used. It was during the debug that we typed the content and it got exchanged. So in similar manner, in this case as well, we are not specifying what content we are going to move. It is just that we are saying whatever content is present in the register has to be moved to the accumulator, and then exchange has to happen between the two address locations. So initially, the content present in R0 has to be moved to accumulator. Then an exchange will occur between the content present in the accumulator and the register R1. You can see here, exchange has to occur between the content present in the accumulator and the register R1. Next, what should happen is that whatever content is present now in the accumulator has to move to the register R0. So let me just consider the first example wherein I am considering in 20H the content was say 00 and in 30H the content was 0A. Okay, so in this line of code, as you can see, this 20H is corresponding to R0, 30H is corresponding to R1. So content present in R0 has to be moved to accumulator. That means this 00 has to be moved to the accumulator. Then an exchange between the content present in the accumulator and the register R1 should occur. That means an exchange between 00 and 0A has to occur. Now the content which is present in the accumulator will be 0A. But in the register R1, it will be the content 00. Right? So effectively, you have exchanged the content between accumulator and the register R1, but whatever is there in the accumulator has to be moved back to R0. So that is why next line of code, that is move at R0, A, what it will do is it will move this content to R0. So at the end of the code, an exchange will occur, and you can see that R0, which was pointing to 20H, will now have the content 0A. And R1, which was pointing to 30H, will now have the content 00. So with this, the first part, that is the first address location, has been exchanged. That means content present in 20H has been exchanged with the content present in 30H. But if you can recall, we have the block size which is equal to 5. So now what we are doing is we are incrementing R0 and we are incrementing R1. So when I increment, it means it is going to increment just once. So when it increments just once, R0 was pointing towards 20H. So the new value of after incrementation, R0 will become 21H. R1 was pointing towards 30H. And the new value of R1 will be equal to 31H. Then DJNZ R3, loop. DJNZ basically corresponds to decrement and jump if not 0. So I am actually comparing the value that is present in R3. Initially, the value of R3 is equal to 5. Now, when I'm going to decrement, it will decrement only once. So, the new value of R3 will be 04. Is 04 equal to 0? No, it's greater than 0. So, you need to jump where? You need to jump back to the loop. So, when you jump back to the loop, what happens is, here you have the content present in R0 to be moved to the accumulator. Now, the entire line of code will repeat. So what happens now in this case is that, let me just erase the previous things so that I can edit it here itself. So now, since R3 is equal to 04, the new value of my R0 is 21 and the new value of R1 is 31. So the content present in 21H has to be moved to the accumulator. So let me assume now in this case, the content in 21H, this is supposed to be 21. Content present in 21H is say 01, and the content present in 31H is say 0B. So whatever content is present in R0 has to be moved to the accumulator. So this 01 will be moved to the accumulator. Then there should be an exchange between the content present in R1 with the accumulator. So this 0B has to be exchange with the content of the accumulator. So now what the accumulator will contain is, it will contain 0B. Now you can see, you need to move the content of the accumulator to the content present in the register R0. R0 is pointing towards 21H, and this is pointing towards, register R1 is pointing towards 31H. So content of this register R1 and accumulator have been exchanged. So accumulator content is 0B. So this 0B content has to be moved to 21H. So the content now becomes equal to 0B for 21H, and the content in R1 will now be equal to 01. So you can see here, we have at the end of this second iteration of the execution of these lines of code, we have effectively exchanged the contents from 21H to 31H. That is, whatever content is present in 21H is now 0B, and whatever content is present in 31H is now equal to 01. Now you are going to increment R0 and R1. So R0 now will contain 22H. Remember, when you are incrementing, it will always increment by 1. So R0 will be equal to 22H, R1 will be equal to 32H, and decrement and jump if not 0. So this value of register R3, when decremented, will become equal to 03. Is this equal to 0? No. Then what you need to do? Decrement and jump if not 0 means, since this value is not 0, you have to jump back to the loop. And again, you need to iterate or go through this entire loop. So in this case, what happens is, now the new value of the register R0 and R1 will be different. So let me just quickly so the new value which we saw just now, when we made R3 to be equal to 03, this was 22H, this was 32H. So R0 is pointing towards 22, R1 is pointing towards 32H. So let me assume the content present in 22H and 32H to be say 02, and this to be equal to 0C. So initially, whatever content is present in R0 has to be moved to the accumulator. So when you do that, the new value of the content of which is present in the accumulator will be equal to 02. That has to be exchanged with the content that is present in register R1, that is address pointed by the register R1, that is 0C. So when I do the exchange, what will happen is that in the end of the exchange operation, The new value of the content present in the accumulator now will be equal to 0C, and this has to be moved to R0. R0 is now pointing towards 22H, R1 is pointing towards 32H. So the content in R0 in this case will be equal to 0C, and the content present in the register R1 will be equal to 02. When you are going to increment R0, the new value of R0 will be equal to 23H. The new value of R1 will be equal to 33H. And what happens is that you need to decrement register R3. When you decrement register R3, the new value of the register R3 will be equal to 02. Decrement and jump if not 0. So this, when you decrement, this is again not equal to 0. So you will go back to the loop, reiterate this. So if I have to tell you the last two steps orally, what will happen is that this address location, that is register R0, will now be pointing towards 23H, register R1 will be pointing towards 33H. Now if I consider the contents say to be 03 and 0D, the contents between 23H and 33H will be exchanged. So you can see that at the end of the execution of this line of code, that is till move at R0, A, the content in 23H will be equal to 0D, and the content in R1 corresponding to 33H will be equal to 03. Again, you will be decrementing the content present in R3, so this will become 01, and you're going to go across the loop and execute these lines of code. Now when you decrement, the new value will be R3 equal to 01, and the last address location corresponding to 24H and 34H has to be executed. Exchange has to occur between the contents which are pointed by 24H and 34H. Finally, when you decrement DJNZ after these lines of codes, what will happen is that here R0 will be pointing towards 25H, R1 will be pointing towards 35H. But when you decrement, what happens is that the new value of R3 now in this case will be equal to 0. So decrement and jump if not 0. But now in this case what happens? This is equal to 0. So you will come out of the loop and you will execute the last line of the code, that is end. So this is how the exchange will occur between a block of data, that is from 20 to 24H and 30 to 34H. Let me quickly show you the debug operation, how we are going to do. So you can clearly see here registers are being used, and we are not specifying anything in terms of the contents which will be present in those address locations. Again, previous code also it was the same thing. We didn't specify anything with regard to the contents. Project, new MicroVision project, I will name this as PP6, and here I need to choose Atmel 8089S52. So we'll save this as PP6 .assembly language program. and then I'm going to add options to target. We'll choose the crystal frequency is 11.0592. Output, create hex file. pp6.asm, add and close. Now I'll go to project, build target. So here you can see zero errors and zero warnings. I'll go to debug, start stop debug session. Okay. Now I have considered the two address locations 20 and 30H, right? So you can see the block size or the array size was considered to be 5. So I need to fill the contents up till the array size 5. So for 20H, I will consider it to be 00. For 21, 01. 22, 02. 23, 03. And this to be 04. Okay. And for the address location 30H, I will consider it to be 0A, 0B for 31, 0C for 32, 0D for 33, and for address location 34, I'm considering it to be 0E. So you can see when I entered here the contents for 20H, I have entered with an array size of 5 between 00 to 04. For 30H, I have considered the contents 0A till 0E. Okay. So this is done. And now I will debug. And the exchange operation should occur in such a way that at the end, result should be that I should be getting from 20H to 24H the contents 0A to 0E, and from 30H to 34H I should be getting the contents 00 to 04. So debug, run, and you can see here 20H will now be having 0A, 0B, 21H, 0C, 22H, 0D, 23H, and 0E, 24H. And the contents in 30 will be 00, 31H will be 01, 32H will be 02, 33H will be 03, and 34H will be 04. So this is the exchange operation between the block of data, and this is basically at par with whatever we have seen here. Contents between 20H to 24H getting exchanged with the contents from 30H to 34H. So this was the end result that we presumed in the beginning, and that is what we have obtained. So in this case, block size was considered to be 5. So if you increase the block size accordingly, just you need to change the program. So here you have the algorithm that is present for the program to exchange a block of data. So initially you specify the origin of the program to be say 0000H. You initialize the registers to hold the count, that is the array size or the block size, and also the source and the destination addresses, whichever you want to use. In our program, we use 20H and 30H. Then you are going to get data from the source location into the accumulator and save it in the register. Exchange the data using the XCH command. Increment the source and the destination address. So you can see we used two increments, register, increment register R0, increment register R1, because we had stored the source and the destination addresses accordingly, right, in those registers R0 and R1. Then we are going to decrement the counting register, that is, we in this case we had used register R3. So we are going to decrement that register and check if it has reached a value of 0. If it has not reached a value of 0, we are going to repeat these steps from step 3 to step 7 until the content in the register R3 or any register that you consider becomes equal to 0. So you are basically performing those important exchange operations and moving the contents within the loop. Okay, so when the content gets decremented and becomes equal to 0, you come out of the loop, and that concludes the end of the code.